could this sleep?
The Home Office estimates 5,000 Iraqis live in Britain, the majority in London and the South East. Most, like Dr. Abu Ali, are political exiles. He was imprisoned and tortured in Iraq for his religious beliefs and membership of the opposition Dawah Party. His fight to bring democracy to Iraq puts him on Saddam Hussein's hit list. He has to take precautions even in London.
Changing addresses, changing cars, not telling anybody about my timetable, not going on regular basis to my office or my home, always looking sort of over my shoulders, there's somebody behind me.
Many Iraqi exiles still have close relatives in the war zone. Mrs. Mohammed has had no news of her husband since his arrest 8 years ago. 13 members of her family are also imprisoned.
I don't like the war because my family and my relative may be killed in this war.
But many who stand to lose everything believe war is necessary to force Saddam Hussein out of Kuwait. The country's national football team was trapped abroad after the invasion and is now playing exhibition matches, acting as sporting ambassadors.
I'm not a soldier. I am a football player. Maybe I can do something to my country in football better than I can do it in the army. You know, I'm really afraid about my family there. I'm really afraid about not only my family, about all my relatives, all my friends are there.
Do you think war is the answer?
By this situation, I think the war is this the answer, because they don't want to make it peacefully.
Mary Marr, Thames News.